Okay, this video is to answer that question of how you're going to get that boat to the water. And the answer is Tulsa, Oklahoma is in the center of the United States, but we are also the most inland port in the United States. And I'm standing at the Tulsa port of Catoosa. And behind me is the Charlie Border, their first tugboat that they had out here. She's been retired and put on display now. So we're only a few miles down the Verdigris River, then 400 miles down the Arkansas River, and then 600 miles down the Mississippi, and we're at New Orleans. So there you go. Twin drive and two rudder systems. I don't know what they call that deal, but they got a rudder in front of the rudder. They can bend a lot of water with that. Oh, nice diesel engine. Okay, we need one of these Samson posts on our boat. There's tread plates we could use in our companionway, but this is kind of nice because it's obviously formed steel, and then they just cut it in sections, welded it in. But the problem, the thing I don't like about this is you can put your foot on through it, which means it's an entrapment. If you fall and your leg goes there, you can imagine that you're hanging upside down from the stairs with a broken leg. Here's a nice little diesel hatch plug down there. Looks like 4-inch pipe, maybe. And, you know, I'm kind of struck when you look at these boats, you know, and people say, well, that well's not flush or whatever. This is their deck plating here, and that's not just paint buildup. That's actually, the plate is up here, crosses over, then it's down here. They have a unfilled weld there. They don't bother grinding any of the welds on the surface of the deck. And this is not atypical for work boats. So when you look at our work, I'm really happy with it. I mean, this is their welds. That's a horrible tie-in. Come on, I would have ground that flash just flat just because I'm embarrassed by it. Here's one of their rudder setups. Looks like it's done in 3/4-inch steel. No, I believe that's 1-inch. Yeah, that's 1-inch. And then 3/4, big 2-inch pins. But again, the welding is, you know, it looks spotty to me. They don't bother to clean up their splatter either, do they? This is my boat. Well, it was when it got here, but Carlisle Steel is out here as well as some other companies. And they all bring their steel in these big rolls. And it goes through a press that flattens them out and cuts them whatever length you want. And so this is a 1/4-inch plate right here. And this is only 4 foot wide. Mine were 6 foot wide. That is a, how much did he say that thing weighed, guy? Almost 100 ton.
Yeah.
It's a turbine, and it's headed up to Kansas. And this thing's a completely self-steering, hydraulically controlled truck bed. And it's interesting, the way they have it slung, they could actually carry the boat. I talked to John about it a little bit. But look at that. Those little things slide underneath the keel, the load, and they're suspended by a chain up to these beams. These beams scissor open. They could actually back this trailer in, close the beams around the boat, and slide the lift pads underneath the keels and pick it up in place all by itself. No cranes involved and haul it. So they're gonna get a call from me. I imagine they're gonna be too expensive, but hey, it'd be fun. And just behind them there, that's the crane that picked that load up out of the river and on from a barge and onto the truck. And that's just a mere 300 ton gantry crane there. They're building a bigger one. Just for a little scale, that thing is about twice as long as our boat. And it's an oil rig portion of one anyway. Well, there we are, Tulsa, Port of Catoosa. 1,000 miles from New Orleans. We'll set in back in there where the crane is. This water's all backed up from the Verdigris River. And a few miles down, there's the Arkansas. That's south, and that's our way out. All right, we're at the USS Batfish, and in all places, Muskogee, Oklahoma. The Arkansas River is right through those trees over there. The navigable channel is over there, so we'll come right past this. Batfish is a World War II diesel boat. But this structure right here is kind of what we're going to do on the aft end of our boat. There'll be a pilot house, and so we need some structure so that we can walk past it. And I want it to be pretty rigid so that
my pilot house roof can stick out over the side and I can still bump up against a pier. Not quite that heavy, but that's kind of the idea.
Okay, for anybody that thinks the ladders on board our boat are steep, this one is perfectly vertical. This is going up into the control room of the Batfish. Wouldn't it be cool to have one of those on our boat?
Oh God, yes.
Look at that big handle.
Live for it. Wow.
Now we're just down the road in Muskogee. We just got through looking through the Batfish. And this is a travel lift at Three Forks Harbor, and big enough to pick up that boat. And I can just see Seeker backed into it. We'll take down the mizzen mast, put her ass end out that way, bow out this way. It's clear span in the middle. There's a way into or out of the water if we need to. Second option. Problem is, this is like, we're not going to probably drive it down here. This is, I don't know, we're 50 miles from Tulsa right now, down the river. About 60 feet, and our mast will be 52, so no sweat for us. There is a bridge in Arkansas that's gonna be a little bit of a problem. It's 50 feet. But all you gotta do is wait for the water to be down a little bit. We'll skirt underneath it. And there's our way south. Only 15 locks between here and the Mississippi River, over 400 miles. Yeah, right here, this is why I don't want a wooden boat. There's his diesel engine sitting inside there. Yeah, he's got some work to do. There's another one. Take your pick. Same problems. Yeah, is that what you call it when a boat gets defaced? Wait. It's been plastered in, but or something, but that's lead behind it. Yeah, that's a big keel. This is kind of interesting. They got there's brass bolts holding the boards on, and they plug the holes, wooden plugs, and you can see the fiber chinking that they're using. So, yeah, that's people say you got a lot of welding to do. Now, I don't have this to do. Something wonderful about Oklahoma is you can drive around, you can find Amish bakeries. We stopped at the Dutch Pantry today. It's great. And Wagner?
Shoto.
And we're back here at Tulsa, and they're getting ready to do a boat show next week. And that's a 45-foot boat right there on just two axles. But what we're looking at is the trailer's really low slung. So, you know, maybe there's hope, but I doubt it, because our keels will be about where those wheels are. Anyway, we're going to look at boat movers, too. All right, so this one's even more interesting because it's got the two axles here. That could be behind the keel, and the skeg could sit out there. Yeah, and there is something to this.